Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. If you need a website, head over to squarespace.com/Paul Messner and you'll get a totally free trial. You'll like this, but not a lot. I wasn't sure myself. As you've probably gathered, today I'm going to be talking about camping mugs. I have three here. This one is the GSI Backpacker, I believe it's called. You've probably seen this one a time or two. The Sea to Summit X-Lite mug. And the third one on show is the Sea to Summit Delta Insulated. We'll take a look at all three of these, so it might give you some idea of which one is best for you. I'm also going to just throw this fellow into the mix as well, my mate Keith. And we'll look at why you may want to choose a titanium mug. So first up, we have the Sea to Summit Delta Insulated Mug. This is made from a BPA-free plastic. Has an insulation sleeve, which can be removed. Has a little toggle to make removal of the lid much easier. There's a soft rubber seal around here, so you get a nice fit for your lid. This weighs in at 106 grams and it holds 473 millilitres, which is a bit random, I think. Two holes in the lid, one for sipping your drink out of, and one's just a breather hole. We'll see how that fares later in the video. This mug costs £10.75, so it's not going to break the bank. So it'll make a nice birthday present or something like that. Next up, we have the GSI Infinity Backpacker mug. As the previous mug, this has got a removable insulation sleeve. This one, however, has got a handle. It's made up of some kind of webbing. It's quite secure. The main container, again, is plastic and it's got some handy little markers in there. And this mug also comes with a lid. It's a little bit different though, because you can close it off and seal it, open it up, and then it just locks into place. This lid is removable, and again, there is a soft rubber seal, so you get a nice tight fit when you put the lid back on. This mug holds 500 millilitres and only weighs 99 grams. Again, very tough material, and there's a little grippy rubber surface on the bottom, so your mug doesn't slip off your table. Sipping hole seems okay, but this bit of the lid catches your nose a little bit. So the GSI Backpacker Infinity mug, a little bit more expensive, £13. Third on the list, we've got my old favourite, the Sea to Summit X mug. This mug is a little bit lighter, 80 grams. It's made of a flexible silicon, and then it's got a hard plastic lip around the top. But this mug's party trick is that you can squash it flat, so you can stick this in your pocket or anywhere in your backpack and you don't even know you're carrying it. As you can see, it's much less bulkier than the other two mugs, but that does come with some trade-offs. First, you can see there's no lid with this mug. You can get them with lids though, but I didn't get that particular model. It's definitely not as sturdy, so you do need to be more careful when you've got it filled with hot liquids. And the only insulation you've got is the silicon from the material of the mug. So you're going to have less protection from the hot contents, and your cup of tea is not going to stay as hot as long as in the other mugs. So this mug will set you back around £12, which is comparable to the other two mugs. And I've had this one years now and it's still going strong, and I take it everywhere with me. That's due to the fact that it's so compact, you don't even know you're carrying it. So I thought I'd throw a spanner in the works and throw a titanium mug in there. This one's called Keith, and it's 350 millilitres capacity. And this one's the lightest of the bunch at only 72 grams. Also comes with a lid, a little tiny handle on there. It's also got handles that fold out. And because it's metal, there's a chance that you'll burn your lips if you're using this to drink out of. I have seen you can get little silicone lip guards that go on these mugs, but I've not managed to be able to pick any of those up yet. this mug excels because it's incredibly versatile. So inside, such a small cup, I can have a coffee, I can have some fuel, and I can keep a stove as well. And because the mug is titanium, I can actually heat it up under a flame. So not only have you got a mug to drink out of, you've got a complete brew kit where you can boil water and even cook a small meal in this. Being titanium, this mug is more expensive. So this is £19 something on Amazon. And you can get them in larger sizes. So you would be able to get something that's 500 mil if that's what you wanted. So here's the final lineup. I'm not going to do any scientific testing. I'm just going to make a coffee in all of them and then leave them in the mugs for 15 minutes and see how easy it is to drink from them all and how warm they keep my coffee. A big thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring the video today. You've seen me editing my website on the computer and the iPad. Squarespace also has some really good apps where you can edit your website from your phone. So from here you can check out all your analytics to see who's visiting your page. I'm going to add a new photo to my gallery. So I click edit, edit my images. I'm going to add a new photo from my photo library. Select one from my favourites. Click done. Really easy to do. So if you want to have a go at creating a website yourself, it's really easy to do. Just head over to squarespace.com/Paul Messner or click the link in the description below. You'll get a totally free trial. You can set everything up, see what it looks like without any obligation. Nothing too scientific. Just going to fill it up. Get the lids on the ones that have them. I'll pop back in 15 minutes. That's 15 minutes gone. Let's see what these are like to drink out of. We'll start with the Keith titanium mug. Now I can't hold the outside of that. The metal is too hot to touch. Probably going to burn my lips. Yeah, that's uncomfortable to drink out of because it's too hot. So although the titanium pot gives you more options so you can actually boil water in it, for me, it's no good as a mug. Right, so next up, we'll go to Old Faithful, the Sea to Summer X mug. So I can hold that, no problem at all. I can still feel a little bit of warmth through there, so the drink is still hot inside. But it's drinking temperature. I could drink all of that in one go. It's not too hot at all. So some of the heat has definitely escaped from the top of this mug. That is the compromise for the flexibility of having something that folds down flat. So next I'll try the Sea to Summit Delta Insulated. Ooh, that is still red hot. In fact, that is too hot for me to drink it at the moment. So the combination of this lid and the insulation around the side has kept the coffee red hot inside. The seal's really good. So I'm not expecting any drips or leaks getting on my Gore-Tex jacket or inside my tent. So yeah, I think that one is quite good. So yeah, I'm impressed with that one. The sleeve does move around a little bit, but that's the only criticism I would say. It's not going to fall off, but you know, it's not as tight as on the next mug. So let's move on to the GSI Backpacker mug. Now, the handle does a job. Quite sturdy. I would like something that is solid, but again, that's a compromise, so you can have it flattened down. I would probably hold it like this and just put my fingers through the loop, and that way I've got a bit of security, so it's not going to slip out of my hand. We'll clip that open. Sleeve on this is really tight, it's going nowhere. Drink is still very hot, although I don't think it's quite as hot as in the Sea to Summit one, but it is still red hot. The lid is very secure, so you're not going to get anything coming out of there. Yeah, I'm impressed with that one. It's not the most scientific of tests, but the things that I need to know is the mug suitable for what I want it for? So this one here, I'm not going to burn my hands on it. It keeps my drink really warm. Same again with this Sea to Summit one. As a camping mug, I don't actually think these two are as good. The titanium one, I still can't pick it up from there. That is scalding hot. It's obviously keeping the coffee warm inside, but it's unusable for drinking out of for me. Me and this mug have been through a lot together. So I'm not going to be letting go of her that easily. Because it falls down flat, it's really handy to have it in your pack. But these two mugs are far superior when it comes to a coffee drinking experience anyway. The Sea to Summit Delta Insulated. Still got the hottest coffee inside. But I do like the feel of the GSI Backpacker a little bit more in the hand. So there we have it, four different mugs. These two are the best for insulating and keeping your coffee warm. They're also very robust and sturdy. The X mug is brilliant if you want something that squashes down to nothing. And for me personally, titanium cups are better for using as a cook pot rather than a drinking mug. Let me know in the comments below if you use any of these mugs and what you think of them. And I hope the video has given you a few ideas to help choose a mug for your camping trips. I'll drop links in the description to all of these mugs. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.